Everybody, it's Kid Catholic Season 2, Episode 25. And before we get started, guys, today is the season finale. So I'm very excited to start Season 3 soon. And actually, September 27th is going to be the 1-year anniversary of Kid Catholic. So I am very excited for that. Anyway, so today's topic will be Father Stanley Rother. I'm going to do an episode on him since he is to be beatified soon. So let's get into it. So Father Stanley Rother was actually the first United States-born martyr ever, so that's really cool. And he was just an ordinary farm boy out of Okarchee, Oklahoma. And his story is when he was in his high school ages, he thought of maybe becoming a priest. And so he got accepted into the seminary, but he really struggled with Latin, which at the time was what the mass was said in. So you really can't be failing in Latin and be in the seminary. In that time, you had to be good at Latin in order to be in the seminary. So for that, he was kicked out of the seminary. And about a yearish later, he was accepted into another seminary. And there he actually graduated that seminary and became a missionary. And he was sent to Guatemala, where he was to be a missionary there. And so Guatemala at the time was not a very Catholic-friendly place. And when he got there, he was a missionary there for 14 years. And so when he got there, civil war was sort of beginning to erupt, and the Catholics were right in the middle of it with all the missionaries there and all the teaching there. And so a ton of Catholics were killed during this time of the civil war in Guatemala. And so for safety, Father Stanley Rother went back to Oklahoma. But when he got there, even though the archdiocese told him to stay, told him, you can't go back to Guatemala, we need you to live, because they wanted to kill him, he said, a shepherd cannot run, which means he can't hide, he can't run away, he can't just leave his people abandoned, he can't leave and leave them there to be killed. So he went back and continued his mission. And one night when he was in the rectory, three men came into his room and killed him. And his bravery was crazy. Even though everybody wanted you to stay in Oklahoma City and in Oklahoma, he still decided to go back to Guatemala, which is crazy. His funeral had a ton of people there, and he was very loved by everybody. In fact, the people who were in Guatemala wanted his body to be buried there, but his family in Oklahoma wanted his body in Oklahoma. So what they did is they actually left the heart in Guatemala and took his body to Oklahoma. So that's a cool fact. Also, about a year ago, the Pope recognized Father Stanley Rother as a martyr. And like I said in last week's episode, since he was recognized as a martyr, he got to skip the one miracle process. So Father Stanley Rother goes to show that you don't have to be living in Rome, or you don't have to live in a big castle, or have relatives who are kings, or be a king. Or he was just an ordinary farm boy from Okarchee, Oklahoma, a small town. Yet he still managed to be beatified, even when he was struggling. He wasn't perfect immediately. He was never perfect. He got kicked out of the seminary, and he was just a young boy from Okarchee, Oklahoma, and he is still getting beatified. It doesn't matter who you are, where you live. If you live up and try to mimic Jesus as much as possible, and if you try and pray to God every day, pray the rosary every day, read the Bible every day, then you can be a saint just like Father Stanley Rother. So, do you guys know what it's time for now? It's time for
the Saint of the Week!
So, today's Saint of the Week will be Saint Kateri Tikawitha. And why I decided to do her is because she is another American-born saint. Well, Father Stanley Rother isn't a saint yet, but he is to be beatified, so he is to be a blessed. So, she is another American-born one, and actually the first American-born saint. So Kateri Tikawitha was in an Indian tribe in what is today the upper New York area. Now in her tribe, the smallpox was going around, and she actually got it several times, and it disrupted her appearance. She didn't look very good, and she was often seen wearing a blanket to hide her face because she didn't look very good. And as a result of the disease that was spread, her whole family died except for her. Her uncle and her aunt then took care of her, who did not like Christians. None of the tribe did. And when, before Kateri converted to Catholicism, the tribe tried to get her to marry, because that was tradition in the tribe. She refused, and she refused again and again to get married, and eventually they were forced to respect that she didn't want to get married. At age 19, she converted to Catholicism, but she knew that Christianity was not welcomed in her tribe. So she then traveled to a different Christian tribe where she was there. And her name, Kateri, actually is the Latin, I mean not Latin, is the Mohawk tribe, her tribe, is that tribe's version of Catherine, which she got from Catherine of Siena. And so Kateri Tikawitha, after she changed tribes, she sadly died 5 years later because she became so ill. First off, because of smallpox when she was younger. Second off, because she would hurt herself a lot, and it was common in her tribe, and she would look at it as a sacrifice to God. But sadly, this hurting herself did not help her health at all, so she did die when she was 24, 5 years later. But this saint, Kateri Tikawitha, is just an overall amazing saint. I mean, she was willing to convert to Catholicism, even though she knew that it was not welcome in her tribe. So thank you guys so much for watching. I also want to say that since today is the season finale, I will be taking a 1 week break for season 3, hopefully try to improve the set a bit, hopefully try to improve Kid Catholic for you guys. And so next week there will not be a Kid Catholic episode coming out. Although the next week after that there will be, which will be the season 3 opener. So the season 3 opener will also be the same episode as the Kid Catholic 1 year anniversary. So that's exciting. Also, don't forget to like my Facebook page, Kid Catholic. And please click the red subscribe button down below and the bell next to it if you're not already. Please comment what you think a future topic and who you think a future saint should be. And guys, thank you much for 2 seasons. It's been incredible, and I look forward to keep going. That was Kid Catholic Season 2, Episode 25, and I will see you guys in 2 weeks.